Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again in this video lecture on the topic gas power cycles. And this is lecture number 13 on gas power cycles. So the topic for today's discussion is problem in gas turbine cycle. This is part 2. In the earlier lecture also, we solved a few problems from Anna University question paper in the gas turbine cycle, and in this lecture we solve few more problems in the gas turbine cycle. The learning outcome for this lecture, at the end of the lecture the student will be able to solve problems in the gas turbine cycle. This is coming under Bloom's level 3, which is application. So knowing the theory, we have to apply the theory for the numerical example, numerical problems. And this is example number 8 from November 2019 question paper. In a gas turbine, the compressor takes in air at a temperature of 15 degrees Celsius and compresses it to 4 times of the initial pressure with an isentropic efficiency of 82%. The air is then passed through a heat exchanger heated by the turbine exhaust before reaching the combustion chamber. In the heat exchanger, 78% of available heat is given to the air. The maximum temperature after constant pressure combustion is 600 degrees Celsius. The turbine efficiency is 70%, neglecting all losses except those mentioned and assuming the working fluid throughout the cycle to the characteristics of air. Find the efficiency of the cycle. Assume R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and gamma equal to 1.4 for air and the constant specific heats throughout. And we take the, write down the given data. T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. Pressure ratio RP equal to 4. The compressor efficiency is 82%, 0.82. The effectiveness of heat exchanger is 0.78. The maximum temperature T3 equal to 600 degrees Celsius, which is 873 Kelvin. And the turbine efficiency is 0.70%. And R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And the gamma equal to 1.4. And this is the layout for the gas turbine power plant. The air is taken from the atmosphere by the compressor and it is compressed to a higher pressure. Then the high pressure air is flowing through the heat exchanger, which is regenerator. So where the heat from the exhaust gases are used to heat the incoming air. The hot air then enters the combustion chamber where the fuel is injected. Hot gases are produced. The hot gases are expanding the turbine and producing the work. Then the waste gases, they are flowing through the regenerator to the atmosphere. And this is the temperature entropy diagram for the gas turbine cycle with regeneration, with the compressor and turbine efficiency. And we have to calculate the cycle efficiency of the regenerative cycle. For isentropic compression process, we calculate the temperature T2 at the end of the isentropic compression. T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is T1 into RP. P2 by P1 equal to RP, RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So this equal to, substituting numerical values, T1 equal to 288, pressure ratio equal to 4. So 288 into 4 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 428 Kelvin. And now we define the compressor efficiency. So, by definition of the compressor efficiency, eta C equal to WS divided by WA, isentropic work by actual work. So, in terms of temperature, it is T2 minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So, we calculate T2A from this equation. So, T2A equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1 divided by efficiency of the compressor. So, substituting numerical values, 288 plus 428 minus 288 divided by 0.8 equal to 458.7 Kelvin. Then for isentropic expansion process, we calculate the temperature after the isentropic expansion. So T4 equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. We know P4 by P3 equal to P1 by P2, so which is 1 by RP. So finally, T3 into 1 by RP to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So substituting numerical values, 873 into 1 by 4 to the power 1.4 minus 1. Divided by 1.4 equal to 587.5 Kelvin. Then again, define the turbine efficiency. Now, turbine efficiency equal to actual work output divided by the isentropic work output. So, in terms of temperature, T3 minus T4A divided by T3 minus T4. So, we calculate the T4A, the actual temperature at the outlet of the turbine. So, T3 minus eta T into T3 minus T4, which is 873 minus 0.7 into 873 minus 587.5 equal to 673.1 Kelvin. Then, with reference to the effectiveness of heat exchanger, so we define the effectiveness of heat exchanger equal to actual enthalpy drop divided by the available enthalpy drop across the heat exchanger. So, in terms of temperature, the actual temperature rise of the air T5 minus T2A divided by maximum temperature difference available in the heat exchanger T4A minus T2A. So, calculating T5 from this equation, T5 equal to T2A plus epsilon into T4A minus T2A. So, substituting all the numerical values, 458.7 plus 0.478 into 673.1 minus 458.7 equal to 625.9 Kelvin. So, T5 equal to 625.9 Kelvin. Then we calculate the work output of the turbine, WT equal to Cp into T3 minus T4A, which is 1.005 into 873 minus 673.1 equal to 200.9. We calculate the work input to the compressor, WC equal to Cp into T2A minus T1, which is 1.005 into 458.7 minus 288 equal to 171.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific work output, W equal to WT minus WC, which is 200.9 minus 171.5 equal to 29.4 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat supplied QS equal to Cp into T3 minus T5. 1.005 into 873 minus 625.9 equal to 248.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the cycle efficiency, eta equal to net work done divided by the heat supplied. So, 29.4 divided by 248.3 equal to into 100 equal to 11.84%. So, the answer to the problem, cycle efficiency is 11.84%. The next example, example number 9 from May 2019 question paper. So, in a closed cycle gas turbine, there is two stages of compressor and two stage turbine. All the components are mounted on a same shaft. The pressure and temperature at the inlet of the first stage of the compressor is 1.5 bar and 20 degrees Celsius. The maximum cycle temperature and pressure are 750 degrees Celsius and 6 bar. A perfect intercooler is used between the two compressors and the reheater is used between two turbines at 3 bar. The gases are heated in reheater to 750 degrees Celsius before entering the LP turbine. Assuming compressor and turbine efficiency are 0.82, calculate the cycle efficiency without regenerator and the efficiency of the cycle with regenerator whose effectiveness is 0.7. The working fluid is air and take gamma equal to 1.4, Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we take the first part. We write down the given data. So, P1 equal to 1.5 bar. We take the diagram and then we read the given data. The cycle efficiency without regenerator. So, this is the temperature entropy diagram without the regenerator. So, first stage compressor 1 to 2 is the low pressure compressor and 2 to 3 is the intercooler. So, the air is cooled. Air is cooled to the initial temperature T3 equal to T1. Then the second stage compressor, high pressure compressor 3 to 4. And the actual compression is 4A up to 4A. Now, the heat is added to the air from 4A to 5 at constant pressure. Then the high pressure turbine 5 to 6, isentropy expansion of the high pressure turbine and the actual expansion of the high pressure turbine. Then reheating 6A to 7 is the reheating. So, actual temperature at the outlet of the high pressure turbine is 6A, then it is reheating and 7 to 8 it is expansion of the low pressure turbine. 7 to 8 is isentropy expansion, 7 to 8A is the actual expansion. Now, look at the pressure. Pressure P1 equal to 1.5 bar. So, P1 equal to P8 equal to 1.5 bar. T1 equal to 20 degrees Celsius, which is 293 Kelvin. And P5 equal to 6 bar. So, here the pressure is 6 bar. So, P5 equal to P4. So, the pressures are equal. P5 equal to P4 equal to 6 bar. T5 equal to T7. So, T5 equal to T7. So, entry temperature to both the turbines are 750 degrees Celsius, which is 1023 Kelvin. So, P2 equal to P3 equal to P7 equal to 3 bar. So, the intermediate pressure is 3 bar. So here it is given as 3 bar. So turbine efficiency, compressor efficiency are equal to 0.82, effectiveness of heat exchanger is 0.7, gamma equal to 1.4 and Cp equal to 1.005. So this is the layout P with temperature entropy diagram without regenerator. Now the compressor pressure for LP compressor P2 equal to square root of P1 and P4. So P1 equal to 1.5, P4 the maximum pressure is 6 bar. So square root of 1.5 into 6 equal to 3 bar. The intermediate pressure equal to 3 bar. Now, so in this cycle, we have to calculate all the temperatures. What are the temperatures like here? T1 is given, T5 is given, T7 is given. We require T2A, T4A, T6A and T8A. All the temperatures are to be calculated. So, using the expression. So, the isentropic compression and isentropic expansion in the turbine. Then, we have to calculate the work done by the turbine, work input to the compressor and then heat supplied. Then, we calculate the efficiency of the cycle. Now we take the compressor temperature. So LP compressor T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma. So 293 into P2 equal to 3 divided by 1.5 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 357.2 Kelvin. Now the compressor has got an efficiency of 82%. So using the compressor efficiency, defining the compressor efficiency eta C equal to WS by WA, which is T2 minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So, T2A equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1 divided by the compressor efficiency. Substitute numerical values 293 plus 357.2 minus 293 divided by 0.82 equal to 371.3 Kelvin. Then HP compressor T4 equal to P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 293 into 6 by 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 357.2 Kelvin. Then again efficiency of the compressor. So WS by WA equal to in terms of temperature T4 minus T3 divided by T4A minus T3. Now we calculate T4A equal to T3 plus T4 minus T3 divided by the compressor efficiency. So this is 293 plus 357.2 minus 293 divided by 0.82 equal to 371.3 Kelvin. Now we calculate the turbine temperature. HP turbine T6 equal to T5 into P6 by P5 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1023 into 3 by 6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 839.2 Kelvin. And defining the turbine efficiency, eta T equal WA by WS, actual work divided by the isentropic work. In terms of temperature, T5 minus T6A divided by T5 minus T6. So, T6A equal to T5 minus turbine efficiency into T5 minus T6 equal to 1023 minus 0.82 into 1023 minus 839.2 equal to 872.3 Kelvin. And for the LP turbine, T8 equal to T7 into P8 by P7 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 1023 into 1.5 divided by 3 equal to 3 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 839.2 Kelvin. And defining the turbine efficiency, so eta T equal to actual work divided by the isentropic work. So, T7 minus T8A divided by T7 minus T8. So, calculating T8A, which is T7 minus eta T into T7 minus T8. So, 1023 minus 0.82 into 1023 minus 839.2 equal to 872.3 Kelvin. Now, work input to the compressor. So, WC equal to work input to the low pressure compressor plus work input to the high pressure compressor. So, Cp into T2A minus T1 plus Cp into T4A minus T3. So, 1.005 371.3 minus 293 plus 1.005 into 371.3 minus 293 equal to 157.38 kilojoules per kilogram. And the work output of the turbine. So, WT equal to high pressure turbine, work of the high pressure turbine minus work of the low pressure turbine. So, Cp into T5 minus T6A plus Cp into T7 minus T8A. So, substituting all the numerical values, 1.005 into 1023 minus 872.3 plus 1.005 into 1023 minus 872.3 equal to 302.9 kilojoules per kilogram. So, heat supplied. So, this is QS into Cp into T5 minus T4A plus Cp into T7 minus T6A. So, substituting numerical values, 1.005 into 1023 minus 371.3 plus 1.005 into 1023 minus 872.3 equal to 806.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And the cycle efficiency is turbine work minus compressor work divided by the heat supply. So 302.9 minus 157.38 divided by 806.4 equal to into 100 equal to 18.04%. So this is the cycle efficiency without regeneration. So considering the compressor efficiency and turbine efficiency without regeneration, this is the efficiency of the cycle, 18.04%. Now we take the same data again. Now there is a regenerator. So we have LP compressor, intercooler, HP compressor, then the air goes to the regenerator and it is heated up to the temperature T5, then goes to the combustion chamber, hot gasser expand the HP turbine, then go to the reheater, again expand the LP turbine, the hot gases are flowing through the regenerator. So this is what the layout for two stages of compressor with regeneration. Now the corresponding temperature entropy diagram. So HP compression, LP compression and intercooling, HP compression, 3 to 4 HP compression and 4A to 5 regeneration and 5 to 6 heat addition, 6 to 7 HP turbine expansion, 7 to 8 reheating and 8 to 9 expansion in the low pressure turbine and 9 to 10 regenerator and 10 is outlet. So heat let given to the atmosphere. Now here there is no change in the compressor work or turbine work. So the pressures are the same. You look at here P6 equal to 6 bar, P6 equal to P5 equal to P4 equal to 6 bar, P2 equal to P3 the same data, P2 equal to P3 equal to P7 equal to P8 equal to 3 bar. So all the pressures are equal. P1 equal to P9 equal to P10 equal to 1.5 bar. So the pressure, there is no change in the pressure of the compressor. And the temperature, look at the temperature. T1 equal to T3 equal to 293 Kelvin and T6 equal to T8 equal to 1023 Kelvin. There is no change in the compressor and turbine work. So only difference is we have to consider the regenerator. So now we calculated the actual temperatures. T2A equal to T4A equal to 371.3 Kelvin and T7A equal to T9A equal to 872.3 Kelvin. There is no change in the actual temperature at the outlet of the compressor and at the outlet of the turbine. Now we consider the effectiveness of heat exchanger. So the heat exchanger effectiveness from this diagram, the actual temperature rise in the regenerator. So T5 minus T4A and then the maximum temperature difference in the regenerator, T9A minus T4A. So actual enthalpy drop divided by the available enthalpy drop. In terms of temperature, actual temperature rise divided by the maximum temperature rise. So T5 minus T4A divided by T9A minus T4A, that is the maximum temperature across the regenerator. So from here we calculate T5. So in substituting T4A plus epsilon into T9A minus T4A, which is 371.3 plus 0.7 into 872.3 minus 371.3 equal to 722 Kelvin. Now there is no change in the turbine work, 157.38. There is no change in the compressor work, there is no change in the compressor work, 157.38. There is no change in the turbine work, 302.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And look at the heat supplied. Now heat supplied, T6 minus T5 plus Cp into T8 minus T7A. Now this is 1.005 into 1023 minus 722 plus 1.005 into 1023 minus 872.3 equal to 454 kilojoules per kilogram. And now the cycle efficiency is 32.05%. So WT minus WC divided by heat supplied. So 302.9 minus 157.38 divided by 454 equal to into 100 equal to 32.05. So there is, earlier the cycle efficiency was 18.2%. Now the with regenerator it is 32.5%. So there is significant increase in efficiency because of the regenerator. So what the regenerator is doing? Regenerator is increasing the temperature of the air, which reduces the heat supplied in the combustion chamber from the external source. So the when the heat supply is reduced, the efficiency of the regenerative cycle will increase. So the main objective of regeneration is to increase the efficiency of the cycle. And we take the next example, example number 10 from November 2019 question paper. The pressure ratio of an open cycle gas turbine power plant is 5.6. Air is taken at 30 degrees Celsius and 1 bar. The compression is carried out in 2 stages with the perfect intercooling. The maximum temperature of the cycle is limited to 700 degrees Celsius, assuming isentropic efficiency of the compressor is 80% and that of turbine is 90%. So determine the power developed and efficiency of the power plant. If the airflow is 12.1.2 kilograms per second, assume Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and gamma equal to 1.4. And there are two stages of compression and one stage of turbine, and we have to calculate the power output when you are given the turbine and the compressor efficiency. And the given data here, Rp equal to 5.6, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 30 degree Celsius, which is 303 Kelvin, T5 equal to 700 degree Celsius, which is 973 Kelvin, compressor efficiency is 0.8, 80%, turbine efficiency is 0.9, 90%, mass flow rate is 1.2 kilograms per second, Cp equal to 1.005 and gamma equal to 1.4. So, for the compressor, we have to calculate the intermediate pressure. So, P2 equal to square root of P1 and P4, 1 into 5.6 equal to 2.366 bar. So, now this is the layout. So, we have a low pressure compressor and the high pressure compressor, and then we have one turbine, and here the LP compressor 1 to 2 or 1 to 2A is the compression, and 3 to 4 is the compression in the high pressure compression, and then 4A to 5 is the heat addition. And 5 to 6 is the expansion of the turbine. So, isentropy expansion 5 to 6, actual expansion 5 to 6A. Then the heat rejection is taking place here. Now, we take the compressor temperature, we calculate the compression temperature. So, LP compressor, the same formula, T2 equal to T1 into P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 303 into 2.366 divided by 1 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 383.7 Kelvin. Now, we define the compressor efficiency, isentropic work divided by actual work, and in terms of temperature, T2 minus T1 divided by T2A minus T1. So, calculating T2A here, so T2A equal to T1 plus T2 minus T1 divided by efficiency of the compressor, which is 303 plus 383.7 minus 303 divided by 0.8 equal to 403.9 Kelvin. And for HP compressor, T4 equal to T3 into P4 by P3 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 303 into 5.6 divided by 2.366 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 387.6 Kelvin. And defining the compressor efficiency again, eta C equal to isentropic work divided by the actual work, T4 minus T3 divided by T4A minus T3 in terms of temperature, and from here T4A equal to T3 plus T4 minus T3 divided by eta C, substituting numerical values, 303 plus 387.6 minus 303 divided by 0.8 equal to 408.75 Kelvin. And turbine temperature, T6 equal to T5 into P6 by P5 to the power gamma minus 1 by gamma, which is 973 into 1 divided by 5.6 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.4 equal to 594.76 Kelvin. And defining the turbine efficiency, actual work divided by the isentropic work, and in terms of temperature, T5 minus T6A divided by T5 minus T6. So, we calculate the actual temperature, T6A equal to T5 minus eta T into T5 minus T6. So, 973 minus 0.9 into 973 minus 594.76 equal to 632.6 Kelvin. So, all the temperatures were calculated. Now, we calculate the compressor work input. So, there are two stages of compression. So, compressor work equal to LP compressor work plus HP compressor work. So, Cp into T2A minus T1 plus Cp into T4A minus T3. So, 1.005 into 403.9 minus 303 plus 1.005 into 408.75 minus 303 equal to 207.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And turbine work equal to WT equal to Cp into T5 minus T6A, which is 1.005 into 973 minus 632.6 equal to 342.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And the power produced by the turbine, gas turbine power plant, so power equal to M into WT minus WC, so 1.2 into 342.1 minus 207.7 equal to 161.28 kilowatts. And the heat supplied equal to Cp into T5 minus T4A, which is 1.005 into 973 minus 408.75 equal to 567.1 kilojoules per kilogram, and the cycle efficiency eta equal to WT minus WC divided by heat supplied equal to 342.1 minus 207.7 divided by 567.1 × 100 equal to 23.7%. Now the answer to the problem, power produced by the gas turbine plant equal to 161.28 kilowatt and the cycle efficiency is 23.7%. So we stop here, and these are all the books I referred for preparing the slide. You can also refer to it for additional information. And I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can refer to it. There are other books available. You can refer to it for more information. I conclude this lecture series with a quote from Dr. Kalam. So, dream is not which you see while sleeping. It is that does not let you sleep. So, you work hard, definitely will be a successful person in your life. These are all the books I published. Design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering and fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload all the video lectures in the subject, and the solution for gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. So, it is absolutely free of cost. You please subscribe the channel, use the video for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. So, thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the YouTube comments box. So, you subscribe the YouTube channel and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So, thank you very much for watching, and we will meet again in another video lecture.